Okay, I've made this video for Bob, made in America, and this is my effort of the high power, high frequency RF dumbing load. My device, this is a generic photo they always use by Johansson. My device has got a terminal on both sides, so when you do measure it, you get your 50 ohms. Some of them are you measure between here to here, and you got your 50 ohms. So. Basically the device part number, I'm pretty sure this is the one I used, around about $27, thereabouts, if you can see that, RF800BB14-004, from, got this one from Element 14, and as you can see the specs there, might be hard to see, but it's 800 watts, and we'll go down to the shed and have a look at my attempt there. Okay, so we're down in the shed. Here's the huge heat sink that I've used. It's quite massive. Put my hand on it, give you a bit of a comparison. It's quite a large heat sink. I'm not sure if I can put something else next to it. Well, there's a coffee cup. So it's quite a large heat sink. And what I've basically done here is bolted the device. I've cut the little aluminium box out, the backside out of it, mounted the device, and nut and bolted it, and I've used some copper shim to wrap it over, solder it onto the earth, and nut and bolt it, and actually also anchor it securely electrically to my RF connector. I've also made a little copper tag that goes straight onto there. So that's basically it, with a nice end connector with a U, and that goes back over, so it's nicely shielded, and it'll handle 800 watts, the specs state, and I should be able to easily get to 23 centimeters with that, 1.2 or even 2 gig, so it'll be quite a nice load, and I'll probably propose to put a couple of fans on there, a couple of fans here. I'll probably bolt them sort of there and over there, a couple of 240 volt fans. That'll make for a real nice compact, high power, high frequency dummy load. I think the total investment for this device is what, $30 for the actual dummy load, $5 for the aluminium case, and a couple of dollars for the connectors there. And of course, the heatsink was salvaged from some sort of device. I think it was off an inverter of some sort. Okay, that's my high powered dummy load. Very cheap and easy to build. Thanks for watching, and as always, stay tuned.